Hey everyone out there in YouTube land, how are you guys doing today? Today, you're in the kitchen with William here, and we are gonna make chicken Marsala. And some of you were asking if I could go ahead and on this channel, cook up some food, and I'm gonna show you guys how I do this. It's a simple dish, not that many ingredients, don't get scared. But you are gonna cook with wine, so that's kind of fancy. Impress the ladies. Okay, so first I prepped everything. You're gonna go with your baby bell mushrooms or brown mushrooms. I use about a half pound. We got all-purpose flour, so you can dredge your chicken in it. And what that does is it gives a nice golden crisp. We got about a half cup to a cup of the parsley. This is fresh parsley, it's organic Italian parsley. You can use the flat parsley if you like. I just prefer the Italian one. And then, oh, there's a little mushroom in here. Then I also did the two cloves of minced garlic. And I sat here and chopped it up myself. Of course, we're using extra virgin olive oil. We also have the Marsala wine. That Marsala wine comes from Italy. It's actually from Sicily. And when this dish, they actually used this dish on ocean voyages that took for a while, you know, and it helped preserve the chicken and everything like that. We're also gonna use some chicken stock. Could be anybody's chicken stock. I just happened to use this one. It was in the store. Butter. And we're also gonna use heavy whipping cream. Okay, so first things first. To serve this dish, you can either do it over pasta, you can do it over rice, or you can do it over mashed potatoes. Today, we're gonna do it over pasta, and I actually picked linguine as my pasta. So I'm gonna show you how to make the sauce, how to make the chicken, put it all together, serve, blah, blah, blah. Okay. And you're gonna need salt and pepper, which is one of the first things we're gonna do. So what I did here is I have a cutting board, and I have the chicken breast, and I have it already sliced up, and it's now on a cutting board. I put plastic on the cutting board as well. So the cutting board has plastic on the bottom, chicken on top, and what we're gonna do is now we're gonna season the chicken, and we're gonna season both sides of the chicken. Okay, so we're just gonna use salt and pepper. And it's about a half, or about a teaspoon and maybe a half a tablespoon of the pepper all together, you know, salt and pepper. You're doing both sides of the chicken. So what I do is I just put it in my hand. So I put it in my hand and I just give it a little shake. So when I aim the camera down here so you guys can see what I'm doing. Let's see here. I don't know if this light is too bright. There we go, that's pretty good. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, guys, is just this. I'm just gonna go ahead and give it a little shaky shake. Okay. Oh, you're on my chicken. There we go, that's all right. That's what happens sometimes when you're on the production crew. Here we go, all right. We give it another little shaky shake. Okay, good thing I have a cover on the camera. Okay. Okay, we got the salt on there. All right, nice. Okay, now we're gonna go over to the pepper. Same deal. I'm gonna give it a little pepper in my hand, and I'm gonna give it a little shake. Now, some people, you can use a shaker if you like. I just prefer to use my hand. I'm old school, what can I say? Okay, now, just like that. Now, just simply take your chicken, flip it over. Now, because I touched the chicken, I am gonna hit my hands up again over at the sink right before, but you know, you're at home and you can do that. I would do it because you don't want the cross contamination of the chicken. That's how you get salmonella. All right.
Go ahead, hit it up. I got my little chocolate snowman over here. You got the soap. This meal is, all said and done, after you prep it, cook it, everything like that, you're looking at a 30-minute window from cooking it, prepping it, cooking it, and getting it to the plate.
So again, we're going to salt this side of the chicken. Hands are a little wet, so the salt can clump a little bit. It's almost like a bad day at the beach. Here we go. Well, when's a bad day at the beach, right? Every day's a good day at the beach. Here we go. Okay. All right. And let's get with some pepper. And we'll season the pepper. All over. Okay, perfect. I like to rub it in sometimes. Oh, that's a little heavy. Yeah, we put that back over the sink so it don't make a mess. Okay, perfect. I got saran wrap. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take another piece of saran wrap and I'm going to put it over the chicken. You're probably going, why is he putting saran wrap over the chicken? Well, I'm going to show you why I'm putting saran wrap over the chicken. Okay, so we got that nice and down. Put it back under the board. Okay, now we're going to take a meat tenderizer. You can use anything. You actually use a rolling pin if you like to, if you don't have this little mallet. Okay, and obviously you're not using the spiky side, you'll be punching through the plastic. You're going to use the flat side. So you just give it a little whack. What this does is actually bring your chicken breast down to about a quarter of an inch. This will help with the cooking process. Also getting that salt and pepper in there. And you see, you don't have to go crazy. Very lightly hit the chicken. Make it nice and flat. There we go. Okay, that's it. That's pretty easy, right? We'll keep that right just like that. Sorry for the dog. Yeah. There's a critic over there. He's barking at me. Alright. Got that, like that. Okay. Let's go ahead and pop you up so you can see what we're doing. I'm gonna bring you guys over to the stove area. Gonna work with this guy today, so let me put this way you can see what's going on. I'm doing it. What I'm gonna do is cook this on medium heat. Okay, got the extra virgin olive oil here. Heating up our pan, okay, we're going to be in, and you're going to use a quarter cup of butter along with your olive oil, and your olive oil is going to be about, you're going to cover the pan. It's okay to go heavy. Teaspoon. A quarter teaspoon, or a quarter cup rather, of butter. And you're just going to drop her right in. Mm-hmm. what this is going to do is you're cooking obviously the olive oil, and the butter is going to give it a nice brown crust. In the meantime, what I'm going to do is I'm going to prep my chicken. So, like I said, we had the chicken there and on the cutting board. Now, after I pounded it, I'm going to dip it into the flour, and that's called dredging. And that's just giving it a light coat. No egg, nothing like that, just all-purpose flour. Smell that olive oil, that smells good. Plus I got the fresh parsley I can smell. I can smell that garlic. Fresh garlic. Nothing like it. Looks like my oil is heating up nicely, so we'll be ready to fry the chicken, which we're not really frying it like KFC fry, we're just trying to get an outer crust. And what we're going to do is we're just going to cook it 3 minutes on each side. Voila, the chicken is dredged. So, you guys closer to me. Where's me wash hands? I got a fork. Check the chicken up. Actually, I'm gonna get a tongs. I'm gonna use tongs, I think. In case you guys are wondering, it is medium and it is on 300 degrees. So, go ahead and lay this guy down here. Little piece of chicken. Like I said, about 3 minutes on each side. Let's see. There's my chicken. It's cooking. It's in there. Okay. Kitchen catcher. And we got our tongs. These tongs don't like me. There we go. It's a weird hook. So we got our tongs. And we're going to let that guy cook. Meantime, I want to clean up a little bit. I did make a little mess with the flour. So. ahead, throw the flour off the cutting board table. Now, we're also going to start our water.
We got to get that going. We got glue going there in here.
I like to add a little salt to the water.
Helps speed up the process. And we also add olive oil. That also helps so pasta doesn't stick. Add that right to the water. Okay.
Put the pepper away, we're all done with that.
Don't need it. Still gotta cook this chicken. It's not all the way cooked. You gotta be careful with chicken. You want it to be cooked on both sides, of course. And you're also going for the temperature of 165 degrees Fahrenheit. This way it's fully cooked. So while that's going around like this, I'm just cleaning up a little bit. It's always easier to clean as you go. Just like the food challenge, guys, if you have anything else that you want me to make, you go ahead and put it in the comments below. I do like tongs because it doesn't tear up your meat. Let me show you what this looks like.
guys can see that right there. I got that little bit of crust going. It's in the olive oil. It's the butter. Looking good.
Now what we're going to do is once we get this heated the way we need it, then we're going to plate this and we're going to put foil on top to keep it hot. And then we're going to make the sauce. Everything goes in this pan. This is like a one pan deal here. While that's doing that, see my water and my oil? They're going around. They're doing their thing. I'm going to use this pasta spoon here. Give it a little stir. Help it get together. You guys hungry yet? Yep, see now I got the, I'm getting that crust that I want. Okay. We're getting there. Look at that, guys. Look at that. See that crust? That's what you want. You want that golden brown. And by using that, the flour, it's also going to help your sauce out because your sauce will help get thick. Okay? Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take a fatter piece. Just want to see if we're ready. Yep, and we're good. We're done inside. Okay. No pain. That's what we want. Chicken.
Look at that.
You guys see that? Looking good, right?
Okay, so now what I'm going to do here, guys, is I'm just going to put the foil on. And like I said, we're going to keep it warm. Wrap the cake. Okay. Now we got these baby portobello mushrooms that I sliced up.
Just gonna add them right to the oil we already have. Okay. Now if you need to, you can add more oil. I don't need to. And what we're gonna do here with these mushrooms is we're cooking them down. We're sauteing them. We're cooking them down. We want them to brown up for us. And then they're gonna get a little smaller in size. And it takes about 5 minutes. Notice I haven't touched the temperature. We're still at 300 degrees.
And that's what your mushrooms are looking like. They're in that butter, they're in the oil. They're melting down. Mm-hmm. Some people don't like mushrooms, but it's part of their dish. And all mushrooms honestly do. They really don't have flavor by themselves. They're one of them vegetables that actually pick up flavor for whatever you're cooking with. They just enhance it. They're like an amplifier. If you had like a guitar, you know, and you're plugging it in, it's an amplifier. See, let's check out our water. See how it's going around. Got the little bubbles at the bottom. It's not quite there yet for the boiling, but it's getting there. Once we do that, we'll add the linguine. Normally, if I had a different pan, I would actually have the handle, and I'd be flipping it a little bit, you know? Really get in with this pan I have right now. These are really nice for big platters. All right, mushrooms are starting to go down in size. They definitely drop. Now we're going to garlic. Yeah, glare. There we go. Garlic don't take long to heat up and get it going. We're going to brown up the garlic. I should invent smell of it. You guys gotta smell this. see it. Let me get in. All
right. See that, guys? See how my mushrooms are looking? The garlic. There we go. Getting it going. We're ready for the wine. Okay.
Three-fourths of a cup of Marsala wine.
Mm-hmm. Got a little heavy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, what we're going to do is we're going to cook it down.
Is also deglazing the pan, they call it. See what it looks like.
Kind of what's going on right now.
Give that a couple minutes, just cook down a little bit. This is what gives it the flavor and makes it the Marsala chicken. Or chicken Marsala. Mm-hmm. I like to cook with alcohol. Oh, and you want to make sure it's the dry Marsala and not the sweet. Sweets for like desserts. Definitely has a woodier taste. Yeah, I can smell the aroma of that wine cooking. Breaking it down. The mushrooms are soaking it up, the garlic is soaking it up. Okay, next, we're going to add the chicken stock, guys. Okay. This is going to be 3/4 of a cup also. Chicken stock in there. And then we're gonna add our heavy whipping cream. This is also organic that I bought. Okay. This is a half a cup. You pour this in slow, but you gotta mix at the same time. Otherwise you're gonna curd it.
will cook for about 5 minutes. Fresh parsley, not all of it, because I'm going to use it some on the top for a garnish. Starting to boil. So we are doing good. We are timing this just right. Now it is a little loose, but the chicken, because it's flour, will tighten it up. And then once this sauce does sit, it naturally just tightens up anyway. But if it's still, if it does continue, you do the old flour trick and it tightens right back up. If you had an issue, if you wound up pouring too much liquids in. Okay. I'm just using box linguine. I didn't make pasta. Ready to add the chicken back in, because you gotta add the chicken back in and you're gonna heat the chicken back up because it's been cooling, even though it is warm. I mean, it's still hot, but you gotta, that's the point. The chicken more sound, it's the sauce. Just a little, I always break it in half so it can fit in the pot better. Simmering, and that's what we want. This is amazing looking. All right. So this is what you want the sauce to look like, guys. See that color? And it's simmering. Now we're gonna add the chicken. Like I
I said, all you're doing is heating this guy back up. In there, get the sauce on them. This guy's stirring, so we don't want our noodles to stick. You and I put oil in it sometimes, you know. You get a noodle that wants to stick on you. To check this out. Look at that. Is that good or what? That's good. Just waiting for these linguine to boil up. We need the al dente, which is firm to the bite. Oh, and I did have people comment on the food challenge. They actually hit me up on Instagram, which you everybody can follow me on Instagram. It is DougJackson1026 at Instagram, and that is open to the public, that Instagram account. And you can also leave me messages on there about what you want me to make or eat for the food challenges. But this week, I believe, I am going to do the Popeye spicy chicken versus the Chick-fil-A spicy chicken. So, that video for that'll be coming out soon. Chicken. just making sure that the chicken has the sauce in it. And it does. I have plenty of sauce to go over my pasta. While that's doing that, we got the seeded roll, the bread. It's all about the bread living in the Northeast. Make my bread in slices, just like that. We're gonna, you can butter them so you can dip them in the sauce later. Let's see, we're ready. Getting there. I'll show you guys how I plate this.
also, I drain the noodles, but then I also like to shock them. And shocking them is just with cold water. You just run it over it while it's in the colander. Drain the water out. Butter and bread. And that is chicken marsala, guys. Alright, I'm gonna go eat this. So you guys have a good night. See you later.